Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I worship your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy. Worship your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. Worship your holy name. Bless you, time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. Worship your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh, my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy name. Yes, I will worship your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. Worship of the King.
One, two.
The lion and the lamb. How great.
brothers and sisters, please stand.
In the name of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Patricia Walker died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I welcome you all to today's funeral. And on behalf of the Cathedral Administrator, the Reverend Father Martin Seju, the Vicar General, I welcome you all. And I invite each and every one of you to sit while we listen to the eulogy. May we all sit and listen to the eulogy. Those who are supposed to give us the eulogy, please come forward. Thank you.
Pleasant good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Wayne Phillip. Miss Patsy was my mother-in-law. Look how many of us came out to her funeral today. She would have hated to miss a big funeral like this. Patricia Anastasia Walker, near Rawlins, was born on the 18th of March, 1950. She was the first of four children born to Hilton and Carmen Rawlins, both deceased. The second of the four children, Neville, is the only surviving sibling. Derek passed away in 2009, and Sheila passed away in March of this year. Patricia was fondly called Patsy by everyone. Patsy attended Providence Junior School and then Providence Girls Catholic School, both in Belmont. There she made a lot of friends who she was still in contact with up to her passing, especially via their WhatsApp group chat. In 1971, Patsy enlisted in the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service. Her career spanned 30 plus years. She retired in 2005 as a corporal. Early in her career, she met and eventually married her late ex-husband, Joseph Newton Walker, in 1975. That relationship bore two beautiful daughters, my lovely wife Avalon and Havana. The Walkers were a well-known and admired couple within and outside of the police service. However, the marriage was dissolved in the 90s and they both moved on. Patsy then shared a common law relationship of over 25 years with Vibert Small until his passing in January of this year. Need I explain that Patsy was hit with a double whammy within a short space of time? It is safe to now say that she was filled with a lot of grief. Yet she showed a brave face. This surely took a toll on her though. Miss Patsy was the most selfless person I ever met. I am sure most of us here can attest to this. Nothing was ever too much for her to do for anyone. Regardless of whatever issue or situation you may have, she was somehow always able to assist. I'm sure you can still hear her reassuringly saying, "Don't worry yourself." If she couldn't get it done, surely she knew someone who could get it done. Or even she knew someone who could get it done. Somehow she always had the link. She was able to make a lot of people's lives better. Miss Patsy loved family. She was ever proud of her daughters and loved them immensely. She took a special pride in her KK. That was her sweet name for her only grandchild, Karim, in whom she was well pleased. KK and his granny really had or shared a unique relationship. Even Avalon and Havana had to keep their lips folded. She would always say, "KK have something to do for me, yes?" When Avalon asked what it was, Patsy would say, "I go and call him." Phone hung up, and that was the end of the conversation with Avalon. Patsy also had a unique relationship with Avalon. Havana can bear witness to this. Avalon was her go-to girl when she ended up in a jam. Avalon and her mom had some exciting events, one of which my wife can never forget. Avalon also attended Providence Girls Catholic School. Patsy was very serious about her school and her image to the nuns in the school. Avalon had to donate items for a retreat. When the sister asked Avalon if she brought in the items, her reply was, "My mother have no money." Avalon only realized she made a serious mistake when Patsy entered Providence Gates to make sure everything was okay for the retreat. One of the nuns asked Patsy, "How come you didn't send any items for the retreat?" Oh boy. Patsy made them call Avalon on the school intercom to the office. Patsy asked Avalon how come she didn't tell her. Avalon told Patsy, "Well, mommy, I heard you say you have no money, so I ain't bother." Patsy told Avalon, "Well, your retreat just over. Get your bags and come and go home." Avalon took about an hour to reach back to the office. She was so ashamed, she told her friends, "Mommy say if they get it on so, don't bother to go." Avalon never made that mistake twice. She was the first to carry items for the second retreat. Another embarrassing moment with Patsy was, Avalon would travel to school on a morning when Patsy could not drop her. One morning, Patsy came home from working night and saw it was 8 a.m. and Avalon was still waiting for her maxi to go to school. Added to that, Avalon was headed to Maraval, then to come back down in the maxi to go to Belmont. Patsy quarreled with her mother, Carmen, for having Avalon do what she wants. Patsy saw a man who she knew driving a school bus with children who were blind and stopped the man. She told Avalon, "Hop on." Avalon played blind on the bus too. Havana was very quiet, or is very quiet and reserved. Avalon would say she proper. Years ago, Havana played dietitian for herself by eating only greens. Havana got very weak and faintish. At this juncture, Patsy was called in. Patsy arrived and asked Havana what was happening. Havana said, "Mommy, I'm feeling weak and faintish." Patsy brought along some boxes of food and told her, "Eat everything, don't leave nothing." Patsy was a very sociable person. She loved going for long drives with her friends and family, always stopping to check this one and that one along the way. She really enjoyed family get-togethers. She participated in the march past at police sports. She loved Calypso, and so she would take pleasure in visiting the Calypso tents during the carnival period and whatever Calypso shows there were during the year. She was an active member of the Police Wives Association and the Police Retirees Association. She was a passionate parishioner of this lovely church. It's just that in recent times, the COVID put a damper on her ability to attend as often as she would have liked. In my preamble, I mentioned that Patsy would have hated to miss such a big funeral. For some strange reason, from since she's small, Patsy made it a business to attend the funerals of persons she knew. And mind you, she knew a lot of people. She hardly ever missed one. She attended quite a lot of funerals during her lifetime. Given the opportunity, a lot of you all would have gladly come up here and testify to the many ways in which Patsy would have touched your lives. Unfortunately, we wouldn't have sufficient time. We have lost a gem in the name of Patricia Walker. She was indeed a rare being. She lived, she loved, she laughed, she cried, she assisted, she supported. She gave of herself to all and sundry. Her journey is completed. the Lord has called her home. Miss Patsy, thank you for sharing your life with us. We miss you dearly. Sleep in eternal peace. Before I end, I recall earlier on this year at Shola's funeral, I asked, and I would ask at this juncture also, we know not the day nor time. Love up your loved ones. Thank you.
Morning to everyone. I'm Neville Patsy's only brother. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. Patsy, she attended the Providence Girls School, and that was the only school she attended. I remember the day she would ride to school and bring home red mango. She had a lot of friends and would bring them home sometimes after school. Marlene, her sister Thelma, Alice, and some of the other names I can't remember. She was a person with a vision. She always wanted to be a police officer. Long time the mounted branch used to pass home by us on horseback, and she would leave home and run to send ride to every policeman. And when they go up the road, she waited until they come back to send ride again for them. And finally, somewhere in 1971, she entered into the service. She was well known and knew a lot of people in society. Due to the job she held, she was always willing to help, to assist somebody to get a job. Matter of fact, the first job I ever had, she contacted a contractor for me to get out work. If you want to go into the hospital, she's there with you. She was a friend and a sister. A genuine person. In closing, to the bereaved family, I say, God is still on the throne. And if we make a stand for God, He will make a stand for us. I can remember in the Bible, the three Hebrew boys, they make a stand for God and they throw them in the fire. And when they look into the fire, they saw a fourth person was there, the Son of God. And God is always with us, and if we put our trust in Him, He will show up sometime in our life. So I pray that her soul rest in peace, and her family will understand that there's a time for everything. And we'll all meet again, maybe at the day of judgment, or we'll all meet up in heaven sometime. So I say thank you to everyone, and God bless in Jesus Christ's name.
May we stand. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Patricia Walker, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through Him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. May we sit and listen to the readings.
a reading from the book of Job. Job said, "Ah, would that these words of mine were written down, inscribed on some monument with iron chisel and engraving tool, cut into the rock forever. This I know, that my Avenger lives, and he, the last, will take his stand on earth. After my awaking, he will set me close to him, and from my flesh, I shall look on God. He whom I shall see will take my part. These eyes will gaze on him and find him not aloof. This is the word of the Lord."
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepare you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May we please sit. Jesus today in the Gospel reading said, "In my Father's house there are many mansions there. In my Father's house, in my Father's house, in my Father's house there are many mansions there. In my Father's house are home. Happy, happy, happy we shall be. Happy, happy, happy we shall be. Happy, happy, happy we shall be. In my Father's house are home." You know, while I was listening to the life of Patricia, all I have to say is she is right there with the Lord. Because it's exactly what the Lord expects of us. Because in Matthew's Gospel chapter 25, Jesus said that on the day of judgment, on the day that the Lord is going to judge the world, he's going to judge the world by our lives, our interaction with people. How caring are we to people? And from what I heard, she has done all. Because it says that when you welcome those who have nowhere, when you give water to visitors, when you invite friends to your house, you dine with them, you lie with them, you care for those who are sick, say, "You are doing that to me." Ecclesiastes chapter 3 says that under the surface of the earth, so there's beginning for everything. There's time for everything. There's a moment when we were born, and there's a time that we are expected to do something. There are certain responsibilities the Lord expects from each and every one of us. And that is why we pick up certain responsibilities, certain offices to serve. Patricia served the nation as a security officer, protecting the lives and the property of all, even those she knew nothing about. It's the most difficult thing to do, to protect the life of people you don't know. Sometimes even your enemy, you protect their lives. And sometimes you risk your life. There are so many police officers today, they were killed at the point of duty. At the moment when they are protecting the nation, people they know nothing about. She did not only serve the nation,
in a civil environment. She also served the church. She was a passionate member of this community. So she has played her role. And we all are here. We are here, all each and every one of us, because one day we shall answer the call of nature. You can call it anything, but we all must answer that call. It's either God is calling you or whatever else is calling you. But we all must answer that call. And when the Lord calls, what shall we say? You know, the song says, when he calls me, I will answer. When Jesus calls me, I will answer. When he calls me, I will answer. I will be somewhere walking for my Lord. When the Lord calls you, what exactly will you be doing? When the Lord demands of your soul, what exactly will you be doing? At what point will you be? Where will you be? It's a very serious question that each and every one of us must ask ourselves. Because when God created us, there are four last things. When we live our lives, depending how many years we have spent, some 70, some 80, some even more, some even less. But at the end of your journey on earth, there's going to be judgment. And that judgment will decide where you are going to. Because that judgment decides if you're going to heaven or you're going to hell. But if we listen to the first reading today, the book of Job, Job made a statement of a believer. He says that when that time comes, when I awake in the other side, I know that my Redeemer liveth. I know that the Lord I serve will not abandon me in the pit of hell, because Jesus will stand constantly before his Father in heaven to intercede on our behalf, because he is our advocate. So if Jesus is your advocate, if Jesus is your intercessor, if Jesus stands before his Father on your behalf, it means that you are the luckiest person. So Jesus said in the gospel, do not let your heart be troubled. So I'm telling the family, do not let your heart be troubled, because Patricia, she knows exactly where she is. She's right there at the right hand of the Father. We continue to pray that whatever it is that she has done, whatever mistake she has done, may the Lord grant unto her a merciful judgment. And for us who are alive, for us who are living, we are here today to pay last respect to her. Tomorrow it could be anybody. It could be anybody. Anyone can be one. It means that we must constantly prepare ourselves. We must be ready at every time. We must be prepared every moment of our lives. Every single day of our lives, we should prepare as though we are going to die the following day. And when we prepare ourselves, when that time comes, we will answer that call with joy, with happiness. So I invite each and every one of us today that as we gather together today in today's Eucharistic celebration, in today's Mass, because the highest prayer that ought to be offered to a faithful departed. Because at the Mass, there's a communion of the saints in heaven and the communion of the Christian community on earth. And we call that the triumphant church. And the militant church, there's a connection. And at the end of the Mass, there is the final movement. The angels accompanies the faithful member of the community to God.
So we pray today, my dear friends in Christ, that as we offer today's Mass for our dear sister, our mother, our grandmother and wife, we offer this Mass for her, that may the Lord hear our prayers and grant unto her a merciful judgment. And for us who are alive today, may the Lord grant us the opportunity to always encounter Him, to always remember that He is alive, to always remember the Lord exists, whatever it is. And we pray that the word of God may be blessed in our lives through Christ our Lord. Amen. And we stand to pray. God Almighty Father, raise Christ's Son from the dead. With confidence we ask Him to save all His people, living and dead. For Patricia Walker, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, hear us. For our dear sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, Lord, hear us. For our diseased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of your goodness, Lord, hear us. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, Lord, hear us. For the family and friends of our dear sister Patricia Walker, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, Lord, hear us. For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, Lord, hear us. In the silence of our hearts, let us commit our dear sister before the Lord and also the family and the children. Lord, hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We make our prayer to Christ our Lord. May we please sit. It's time to take the collection.
Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hand have made, I see the stars. I hear the roaring thunder. Thy path throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son, not sparing, gave him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross, my burdens gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sins. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart, and I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. How great, how great, how great, how great thou.
May we please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours to be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands
For the praise and glory of his
name. Good and good and glory.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Patricia Walker, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is only right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gate, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like they do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command, at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which shall be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Jason, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Patricia Walker, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Thou with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her mutual spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may marry to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we're there to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and I shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us a life everlasting.
Just a gentle reminder, my brothers and sisters, Holy Eucharist will be given out now. We urge that only Catholics, we know there are many people here from different denominations, but communion for the Catholic faithful.
Please may we sit. For the Catholic, those who are prepared for the communion. Thank you.
Everybody, Jesus is calling. Calling for you and for me. See, the world else is waiting and watching. Watching for you and for me.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant us strengthened by it, our dear sister Patricia Walker, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. May we please sit for the final interment. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our dear sister, Patricia Walker. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
To
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our dear sister Patricia Walker in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Patricia Walker in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our dear sister forever. Amen. We gather here to commend our dear sister Patricia Walker to God our Father and to commit her body to the earth in the spirit of faith and the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Let us offer our prayers for her. Because God has chosen to call our dear sister Patricia Walker from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth. I want all of us to stand. May we all stand. The Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our dear sister Patricia Walker to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise up her body on the last day. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of a sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let the perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed show the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. At this point, I want to, in a very special way, on behalf of the family in the cathedral, welcome each and every one of you and appreciate and thank you for coming to be there for the family. May the Lord continue to bless each and every one of you as you depart from this cathedral of Immaculate Conception. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you both now and forever.
Amen.
Go forth glorifying the Lord by your life.
We wait upon the Lord, we will wait. You come for those in need. You